best life now, the second step, and which we'll talk about on today in living your best life now, is this. You must develop a healthy self-image.
All right.
I said you must develop a healthy self-image. That simply means that you must base your self-image not on how you see yourself, but you must base your self-image on how God sees you and what God says about you.
All right.
I've discovered in life that when it comes down to me, that it's not all about me, it's still all about God.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So members of Redemption Life, can I ask you this question this morning? Who do you think you are? In the text, the Bible says that David left the flock in care of another shepherd.
All right.
Understand that David himself was a shepherd.
All right.
And if you remember when we first encountered David, David was out in the fields tending to the sheep.
Yeah.
And his father, Jesse, didn't think enough of David to even invite him to his own installation ceremony. It was right there in the field that David was installed as the man of God. It was right there in the field that Samuel anointed David, and the Bible says that the Spirit of God fell on David and he became the new shepherd. Listen, David had been a shepherd by occupation, but God had chosen David to be a shepherd by vocation. You got to understand that there is a difference. You see, you need to know that everybody that works in the church is not doing the work of the church. Everybody that works in the church is not doing the work of the church. There is a difference, but that's a sermon for another time, amen. I just wanted to put your head in your pocket. Oh, let me tell you one more time, just in case you get it. Everybody that's doing the work in the church is not always doing the work of the church. But David was a shepherd. In other words, David knew who he was. I can remember that there was a time when I began to think out that I was somebody. You know, like old folks say, you begin to smell yourself. You know, he finished himself. That was a time when I started doing what I wanted to do. Started going in places that I wanted to go. Hanging out, ladies, I wanted to hang out. And if you know my mother, you know my mother wasn't going for that foolishness for too long. And I can remember that she would meet me at the door when it was unlocked. And she looked me in my face and said, boy, who do you think you are?
Yeah.
I hear God asking that same question on today.
Yeah.
Says, who do you think you are? Don't you know that you are fearfully and wonderfully made? Don't you know that I made you in my image and in my likeness? You were designed to have dominion.
Yes, God.
You were created to be conquerors.
Yeah.
God says you are handcrafted to be holy.
Yeah.
He says you were made to be my greatest masterpiece, which means I picked you out to be a peculiar person. God says I shaped you and sculpted you for you to stand up and to stand out. He said, I made you to be the head and not the tail. I made you to be the lender and not the borrower. God says, and for you to be anybody else, be anything else than who I made you to be, who do you think you are? Is anybody in this room? I've discovered that in order for you to know who you are, you got to know whose you are.
That's right.
In other words, can't nobody tell you about you like the one that made you.
That's right.
If you want to know about creation, you have to consult the creator.
Yeah.
If you want to know about the product, then you have to talk to the product designer.
Yeah.
Only God can truly tell you who you are.
Yeah.
Come here, Simon Peter. If you remember, Simon thought because he caught fish for a living, that he was a fisherman.
Yeah.
But it wasn't until he began spending time with God that God revealed to him that he was more than that.
Yeah.
Said, Simon, just because you catch fish as an occupation don't mean that's who you are.
Yeah.
He says, Simon, I've called you to be a fisher of men.
Yeah.
Simon was a fisher by occupation.
Yeah.
But he was a fisher of men by vocation. There is a difference. See, an occupation is what you do. A vocation is what you're called to do. You got to understand that God is not only the giver of life, but he's the giver of our purpose in life. And you got to understand that your purpose is packed with identity. Let me say that again. You got to understand that your purpose is packed with identity. So if you want to begin living your best life now, not only do you have to know who you are, but you got to know whose you are. Can I make it plain? See, some folk will get stuff because of their last name. Right about now, if your name Obama, you can go in any store and get just about anything. Depending on what store you go to. There's some folk that already care for the last name. But his daughters are going to receive things because of who they are. And whose they are. And if you got to understand that they have favor because of their last name, just think about the favor that we have on us because of who we belong to. You haven't got these shits. You got to understand that you're not just any old body. You are a child of God. Which the Bible declares that you are a royal.
Yes,
I can stop right there. I don't want to get the priesthood. But you are royalty. You're residents of the heavenly kingdom.
Yes,
and if you're a resident of the heavenly kingdom, then you have some favor right here on earth. The reason why you haven't enjoyed that type of lifestyle is because you don't really know whose you are and who you are. Again, you are kings and queens. Your daddy is the king of all kings. He's the Lord of all lords, and he has everything in his possession. So the cattle on a thousand hill belongs to him. He's the giver of every good gift, and the reason why you receive what you do receive is because of God. Look at your neighbor and say, I am royalty. As soon as you know who you are and you walk in that authority, people start treating you different. But you know, celebrities don't have to pay for no clothes. They are already rich and they still get free stuff. But you are a child of the king. That same favor don't just rest on them. That same favor rests on you. In order to live your best life now, you have to know not only who you are, but who you are.